What is going on, folk? It's Nimblethaw here, and there are two things you should know about this video. And the first is that it's a celebration of my 200th Mobile Gaming Quest video. So thank you so much for the continued support. It really means a lot to me, guys. Now, I've actually covered over 500 mobile games here on YouTube, but 200 videos ago, the quality got a big bump up, and that's when I decided to launch this series called My Mobile Gaming Quest. So as a way to keep improving and evolving the channel and to celebrate the milestone, I have launched the community section of this Nimblethaw YouTube channel. So what does that mean and how will I use it? Well, I figured that I would use it to share mobile gaming news and updates that might not make it into a video on its own here on YouTube, but that I think you guys will really be interested in. And if you think that sounds great, then listen very carefully, because there are actually two different ways that you can see these community posts. And the easiest way is simply by subscribing and then hitting the notification bell. And the second way is by visiting the channel and then navigating to the community section. So really, just hit the notification bell and you should start seeing these videos pop up in your feed. Now, don't worry, I don't want to spam you guys, and in fact, I might start out with just a single post every week or so. Depending on how you guys respond to them, I might then do more, I might do fewer, really. It really depends on what you guys want to see from me and see from the channel and how you want us to interact. So I hope you're up for that, and I hope you'll hit the notification bell, so I will see you guys on the other side. Now, the second thing you should know about this video is that it's the first portrait mode game that I'm covering here on the Nimblethaw channel. So will I finally start doing more of these from now on? Well, I might, but that depends a bit on what you guys think. So far, I've only covered landscape mode games, but do you want to see more of these portrait mode games? Let me know in the comment section down below. But anyway, I decided to play Knights of Fury today because I kept seeing an advertisement for this game, which is published by Candy Crush developer King, by the way, which initially made me steer away from the game, but the art style and just the overall animations and combat really drew me in. And so today we're checking out the beta release of Knights of Fury, which is a casual RPG for both Android and iOS. Now, if we just stop up here for 1 second to have a look at the actual combat and what you can expect from this game, you'll see that we have to take out a couple of different units here in the 3rd out of 3 rounds in this level we're in. So both this guy over here and this guy over here have shields left. So what we want to do with those is we want to do a fist attack, which we can do by tapping the left button, and we deal a lot of damage to the opponent's shield. So we want to do 3 of those, and that's it for this round. Every round in this turn-based combat, we have 4 different attacks that we can do, and then the opponent will attack us, and then we can do 4 different types of attack as well. So now that there's no more shield left, what we want to do is go straight for just a normal attack by simply tapping the screen to kill the enemy. KO! Awesome! Oh, we should have done 1 more shield attack there, or fist attack. And there we go, KO for that unit as well. Only 2 units left now, and it looks like we're actually gonna win this match. Now, we do have some special attacks that we can do as well. Let me just show you guys, though. So those are in the bottom right corner. You can look at them as sort of skill attacks, but they're really using one of the other heroes that we have with us. KO! Awesome. And let's use this archer over here to do a guaranteed KO as well. Yes, because there was nearly no HP left. That is awesome. That's it for the combat, though. It's super simple. It's very casual, as I said. It's turn-based. 2 different types of attacks. 2 different types of skill attacks or special attacks. And then actually, there's one thing that I didn't show you guys, but if we do enough fist attacks, we can do a very special attack. I don't know what you'd call that, but like a unique attack using that as well. Now, what we then do is we go through these campaign missions here, and in between doing these normal battles, we can also level up our units, for example. All that good stuff is in here. So if we go over here for 1 second, I want to just show you guys that I've had some heroes being trained, and now we can claim some more of the shards that we need to level up those heroes. So this one is now level 4. We definitely want to add that one to our team as well. And I think that's just about it. So now let's go in and modify our team. If we go in here to our knight in the bottom right corner, we can go over to heroes up here, and we can swap out Ash here for Wormwood. Wormwood is really awesome because he can add shield back once it has been depleted. So we definitely want him on our team. And then instead of Helmar up here, we might want to go for, just want to go for Grimm, which is another really great hero that we've unlocked already. So now that we've got that changed, we can go in and we can upgrade our different armor pieces. I think we could definitely use that before we go into the next battle. So let's upgrade the legs here. Look at this. Look at this. I love the animation. It's just so humorous. But anyway, we can upgrade here and we can spend some of this Tellurian bits that we've gained from, well, simply playing the game, opening chests, completing missions, and so on. So now we level that up a tiny bit. We might want to go in and upgrade some of the other parts of our armor as well. Maybe the arms? Yeah, let's upgrade the arms a bit. So let's go in here and fuse again. We use the same types of bits for this that gave us 6 extra armor. And we could go in and upgrade, you know, we could go in and continue with this. We can also go in and upgrade our weapon, I think, right? Yes, we can upgrade our weapon, for which we use vulcanite bits. So let's do that. Oh, we need to tap a lot of times to level this one up. But at least that's gonna add 4 extra damage, which is actually quite a bit out of only 34 before. So 4 out of that is quite a bit. That's nearly 10% increase, I think. Close to a 10% increase. So now with that upgraded, we could choose to go for the boss battle up here, and I want to show you guys that. But just before we do that, I just want to see if there are any daily quests that we've completed, because that might give us a new chest or a new armor piece. There weren't really a lot that we had completed so far, but what we can do is we can go in here to the store, and we can open one of these free chests that we can open every 3 hours. And we actually got some new legs, some rare ones even. But it looks like they're worse than the ones we have right now, which might be because we've upgraded the ones we have right now already. But it could also just be because the new one wasn't really that great. I'm not even sure. We have to go in and look at that. We also have a gem chest, which we can use premium currency to open. And this is how the game monetizes. If we go over here, you guys can see that they sell these premium currencies for up to $100. But surprisingly, the premium currency is actually only used to get new items through loot boxes. We can't really use it on a whole lot else. And even though, yes, there sadly is an energy system in this game that really sucks, and I'll explain how the energy system works really soon, there's no way to get more energy by spending premium currency, which is great because it means that hardcore players or players that spend a lot of gold on this game, or money, real life money on this game, won't simply be able to get a huge advantage over us free-to-play players or casual players, because there is a limit to how much you can actually play at a time. But with this upgraded, let's go back in to the boss fight and see if we can complete it. We have 88 energy right now, which is plenty. We only need 6 to go into this combat here. And now, I really hope we'll be able to do this one. I think this one is gonna be the real final test. Has it been worth it to go in and upgrade our different armor pieces? Alright guys, what are we looking at here? They all have armor, so to start out, we just wanna do a couple of fist attacks to take out some of that, and then I think maybe one normal attack here. Yes, that's great. That's really great. We actually took out that guy, and that means that he won't be able to attack us. So that was great. So let's try to do the same with the guy over here. So there's only the one in the middle left at the end. So let's do one more, and then a KO here. Yes, there we go. Ultimate chain, plus 50% damage. Enemy turn. He is dealing quite a bit of damage to us, I will say. So maybe it's soon time to use our special unit, which will be able to regenerate some of our shield. But I think we're just gonna go for dealing some damage to the opposing enemy shield here, and then a normal attack. Right now, we have to figure out, do we want to use the special power in the bottom left corner, or do we want to just continue with normal attacks? I think we're just going to continue with normal attacks, yes, because there was a KO. We definitely want to save up the special power for the boss, and there's the boss, guys. Look at that. Look at him. Oh my. Okay, so let's use a special attack right now. Which of our heroes do we want to unleash? I say we use Acid Rain. That sounds so awesome. Acid Rain. Wormwood, use Acid Rain. Look at this. Oh my, the animations, the art style, everything about this game is just pure awesomeness. I don't know what it is, guys. Let's attack the shield over here. And there we go. The shield is nearly taken out. But I think all of these has gotten acid on them right now, so they will probably take damage over time. I think that's how it works. Yes, as you guys can see, they're taking damage every time they've attacked us. And they'll do that for 3 rounds. That's really awesome. So now I think it's time to use Wormwood to recover some of our shields. Let's see if that actually works. Let's use this attack here. Wormwood, wooden armor. And it worked, because as you guys can see, we now have a tiny bit of shield. We are pretty low on HP though, so we have to be really clever about what we want to do here. Do we want to just go for this guy? I think we're just going to go for this guy with 2 normal attacks, yes, and we can jump over here to do another KO. And that's it for now. Alright, alright. At this point, we've got 2 archers left. We've got the guy in the front row, and we've got the boss at the end. So let's take out the guy in the front row here. Let's use a Vigor potion, which I think is gonna recover some health. Yes. Awesome. And now let's use a special attack from Grimm, which is gonna be Ice Needles, which didn't really work. Normally, the Ice Needle can actually freeze the opponent, which is really great, because then they won't get to attack, obviously. But it didn't work on the boss, it seems. So, what can we do now? Can we actually attack the archers? Yes, we can. Do we want to do that? There's one archer left. I say we do that, and we swipe over here, and we try to take out this boss here just as soon as possible, because I think he's probably gonna kill us really fast if we're not careful. Look at how much damage he deals. That's just so unfair. Okay, let's do a few more attacks here with our fist, and we might have enough to unleash our special. Yes, we had enough. All right, so I say we use Sap Life, the skill up here, which is gonna recover some of our HP, and it's gonna deal damage to the opponent, which was only 66? Only 66 damage? What? No, guys, no, we're definitely gonna lose this one, right? I just know we're gonna lose it. Yeah, we're gonna lose it. He's gonna kill us now, I think. The only thing we can really do, though, is to use a haste potion, which will give us some of the energy left. Let's do that right now. And as you guys can see, it will give us some action points left. And now we can try to attack the opposing unit. And no! Guys, that was nearly enough. He has so little HP left. Are we gonna die now? That is just so unfair. That is so unfair. We lost a life. We died there with so little HP left on the boss. Oh, man, that sucks. Oh, wow. Okay, guys. But I think that's gonna be it for this video, though. I think this has been far long enough. We've got guilds in here as well. We've got a lot of great stuff that you guys should definitely go explore if you think some of what you've seen so far seemed interesting. Will I keep playing? Yes, surprisingly, I will. This is such a finely calibrated game. The progression just feels really rewarding. And it's clear that these developers and publishers really know how to get me hooked. Will I grow bored of the game eventually? I might, because the combat isn't really that interesting, but because the battles are so difficult, it keeps me interested and keeps me coming back. For example, right now, I really want to go in for another round with that boss, because I think I might have a new strategy that could take him out. But for now, thank you so much for sticking around till the end of this video, and here is the mobile gaming news of the day, which is that Huawei will attempt to take on the Nintendo Switch with a $1,000 gaming smartphone that will release already on October 26th, so very, very soon. But at such a high price and without the Nintendo games that we all love, would you even be interested in something like this? And is it really a Switch competitor? Let me know what you think about that in the comment section. And until next time, just keep gaming, stay awesome, and I'll see you guys around.